Hello everyone, welcome back to Afterbirth. Plus, if you didn't see the stream, we had some fun. We, in fact, if I remember correctly, we did beat Greedy Ermode as Azazel, which was super fun because at the time I'd had more than enough to drink. I think we're going to play a hard mode with the new character, Apollyon. I will probably already by now have put the stream up on YouTube, or at least the interesting parts thereof. What is this? Why is my headphone being weird? Please, excuse me. Oh, I'll pull it out. I have a headphone splitter. There we go. Nope. And it's really loose. And I have a headphone splitter because obviously we play, you know, two players on the same stream sometimes. There we go. It's really loose, so it keeps making horrible noises. I'm cutting out all the time. So the reason I have gone in here now is that this is not an XL floor, and I want to make some good use of our spacebar item, which we learned about on stream. The void item either, well, it always absorbs a item pedestal. If it's a spacebar item on the pedestal, then the void item will collect the spacebar item and will have the effect of the spacebar item every time you subsequently use the void. And if it is a passive item, then it just upgrades random stats, or possibly even downgrades some random stats. It's a little bit hit and miss. I don't know whether the upgrade and downgrade, in fact, is based on... Do we want little horn? No. Let's get a luck upgrade, which is fairly common, actually, from this, but also the speed upgrade is really nice early on. We might as well recharge it for free, thank you, and take a coin for free. I don't know whether the upgrade-downgrade is based on what the item would have done. I don't think Little Haunt has anything to do with speed or luck, but then that might be the sort of the defaults if there's nothing else to do. I haven't looked up what the item does in any specific way. Like, that's sort of... inside baseball, as Northern Line calls it, information. All I know is if you take a spacebar item, you will always get that effect when you use the void in future, and if you take a passive item, it will give you some stats. It's pretty interesting, and we do get some interesting outcomes from this, but you can see that we've only beaten, I think, Mom's Heart as Apollyon right now. I've been hearing some very mixed reviews about Afterbirth. Right, okay. I'm quite excited to be playing Afterbirth Plus. There is new items, there's new stuff to unlock, there's new stuff just generally to do. I'm pleased with it. Little Horn here has a bigger brother in the form of Big Horn, which is an asshole of an enemy. This is not it, this is Little Horn still. We're okay for now. There's new champion versions of some bosses. And there's a whole new floor, which we will get to at some point. I don't know if I want to spoiler it right now. I expect that if you're watching this video, you're probably fully aware of all the ins and outs of Afterbirth Plus by now, because you probably watch other people play it, is what I'm expecting. But the new floor, people are thinking that it's a very lazy sort of floor. And I think a lot of the problem... with Afterbirth Plus right now is that it came out, it was apparently delayed, which is why our stream was actually a day late. It was delayed by 4 hours, which was the 4 hours in which I was intending to stream. Well, I was probably going to do two or three, but you know what I mean. This fight's taking forever. Let's just address that. Let's not let that particular piece of information fall by the wayside. We are taking forever to kill Little Horn right now. But the fact is that... Oh, I fell down the hole. Afterbirth Plus came out just after... This is shifting. Oh. Well, we got a damage upgrade, which is pretty nice. Afterbirth Plus came out just after Antibirth, which is a community mod, a mod for Rebirth, not Afterbirth, certainly not for Afterbirth Plus. So people have put a lot of effort into making Antibirth, and it's considerably better, we have to be honest, than Afterbirth Plus. The amount of content in Antibirth, the amount of detail, the amount of imagination, the amount of everything is just It overshadows Afterbirth Plus. Which is understandably very disappointing to many people. Now, personally, I'm happy to see... that was a really bad dodge. Just new stuff from the makers of Afterbirth Plus, but I feel that, you know, having watched people play Antibirth, I haven't played Antibirth myself, or there would have been a stream or a series on it, but I thought I would probably wait. The fact is that, you know, Afterbirth Plus was paid for, and Antibirth was not, and yet Afterbirth Plus seems to be, at least at first glance, not that good compared to it, which is obviously very disappointing for many, many people. Including for me, I have to say that I feel like Afterbirth Plus could have been a lot better with the actual original creators creating even more content for, you know, the game, putting things in that they believe to be canonical, which, you know, if they create it, it is, right? But some of the new items and things really do feel like they're not really putting that much effort in. Like, a lot of the new items that I've seen just play on old themes. There's at least two new items that let you pick up... Ow, that hurt. Two cards or two trinkets. So we already have a two trinket item, we already have a two card item, we already have a two pill item, and we already have an item that allows you to carry two cards or pills. And yet, now we've got even more of those things. Whereas in Antibirth, the actual effects that the new items that they've created have are worlds apart from the ones that you already see. Leave me alone, please. You know, the new bosses are very differently designed. There's one boss that just, you have to beat waves. There's one boss that has three sections. I think we do want to take Mom's Pill. And I think we go for Devil Precedent and take this as well. The range and luck upgrade are pretty good. I mean, we like luck, because it could in the future give us a much greater advantage. So we want to find our item room if at all possible. No way of getting any of that. I do recognise there's a tinted rock there. I'd like to find a secret room, so we really need more bombs. Which I guess the luck upgrade could help us with. You may or may not consider it lucky to be fighting rock at this stage of the game. But now that it's actually cleared a path for us, I'm sure we can manage it a little bit better. There you go. Black Powder already doing its job, making its place on the team known. So I can understand mixed reviews for Afterbirth Plus. And honestly, in and of itself, it's kind of not that great. As mentioned, even if we didn't have Antibirth alongside it to sort of compare it to, which is probably not necessarily, you know, fair. You know, you can't really compare. It's apples and oranges sort of thing. Secret room? Nope. Now looking for keys. Keys, please. Keys, please. These are not keys. Key, please. Pretty sure you can't give me a key. Got an Empress card. Well, Spirit Heart is fine, but it doesn't really pay the bills, if you know what I mean. As far as I can tell, we have not used up a key, and therefore there's no way to get to our item room. That's okay. We can't win them all. So let's talk about this run. I appreciate the fact that we have been given a damage upgrade already. We're going very slowly, actually. I will drink some water. I appreciate the potential. There's a lot of potential in an Apollyon run, in any Void run. I assume that Void is pickable up. But if you don't have it from the start of the game, it's probably fairly difficult to justify taking it. Ow. And I'm not entirely sure that you can. Excuse me, I'm pretty sure that was a circle. Thank you. Probably got a little bit too focused on trying to use black powder, if I'm being honest. I was just about to try not to walk into that. We're going to die here. Probably use the devil card, try and get some damage out of this. Oh, careful. hate this room. Because the shots go so far. At least we don't have to wait for them to pop up. Very difficult to dodge fire shots. I have a blind spot for dodging any amount of fanned out shots that are, you know, coming right for us. Second hand, we don't have any stats to extend the effect of, but at the same time, there's no reason not to take it when we don't have a trinket either. I'm trying to use black powder because I want, if they turn into bonies, I would like that to be, you know, the last thing that they do. They didn't, but I think it's still the right play. We do have a key. We could go to our item room. I think the exciting thing about the void item is collecting spacebar items in it. Having the ability to just sort of... interesting. Having the ability to sort of arbitrarily create random stats is probably not as powerful as it sounds. I'd like to kill this thing because it's cramping my style. There we go. I mean, anything that's basically trash, you try and get some decent stat upgrades out of it, for sure. But, you know, we haven't picked up any real decent value out of that, and we haven't picked up any spacebar items at all for our void item to be any use to us whatsoever right now. So, I'd like HP. We have a good luck stat, so I'm surprised that nothing's really dropping for us. These things can be quite dangerous. I mean, the mushrooms, of course. We know about flies. They can also be quite dangerous. They sort of hide out for a while and then go, hello. It's like a game of peekaboo with a child. Ooh, that was very lucky, and this could be very dangerous, so... yep, watch out there. I mean, it's not like it matters if a champion hits us over anything else. Good grief, how much HP do you have? All of the HP in the world? There we go. Again, I would like some, oh, he hit me. Right, let's try this again, without being bad at the game. I'm finding that Apollyon has, seems to have fairly low stats. I mean, I think 3.5 is Maggie starting stats, not Isaac. When I played it the other day on stream, I thought that it was Isaac's stats, but no. I think 3.5 starting damage is reasonably low. And it doesn't have Maggie levels of HP either. Slightly faster than Maggie. I think one speed is very default. Bomb bag is probably worth taking instead of trying to scum some random stats out of. Starting to feel like my Isaac runs are just like Cataclysm runs right now. Well, my Apollyon runs. Somewhat like Cataclysm runs. You start off with some random stats and try and upgrade them as much as you can. Using nothing but variants. That was really terrible. I assumed that the shot would have ended by the time I came back around to try and do anything about it. Bomb bag could give me a bomb and then I could get the spirit heart and be happy. Well, that's a tinted rock. It may not be a spirit heart. There are two locked rooms, one of which could well be a library. A library. Please leave me alone. I do not want your attention. Having this low damage means that champions at this stage of the game are causing us great difficulty indeed. Especially when they turn into goo on top of a rock, which I think is just bullshit. Help. Alright, let's kill the not champions. Get rid of everything except for the one that takes longer to kill. That would be a good idea. There we go. I mean, currently our spacebar item is literally zero use. And I've taken a lot of damage because I'm bad, as we've mentioned. Finding it a little bit more difficult to get the wind under my wings with Apollyon. We should, I would very much like that item, because it's a good item. So we should see if we are actually going to be able to get the opportunity to, even if we end up with, you know, how to jump or something like that. We'll fight the boss. It's possible that the library contains how to jump, so it's not actually unthinkable, but we will probably, if that happens, I guess we could swallow how to jump and then use it in future. But do note, if we were to take how to jump into our void, try to use it to pick up Evil Eye there, We would swallow Evil Eye before we activated How to Jump, and then there wouldn't be anything on the pedestal for us to get in the first place. So we do want to use How to Jump if we can find it. Or just a Hanged Man card will do, I suppose. The interesting thing here, of course, with the Void is that normally you go, that's an okay boss item, I'm happy with it. But with Void you'd go, do I want to reroll this into some random stats, especially for something like HP up. It's the box, which I think we take because of all the stuff it contains. The Fool card, it's not a Hanged Man, everything's what? I didn't even read the thing because I picked up the Fool card again. Oh, the Fool cardigan. We will go to secret room. It is not the secret room. That is outrageous. How is this not the secret room right here? It only contains the Necronomicon, which we take and then put back down and reroll. Now we've taken it, which gives us a, not reroll, but absorb. So I want the Ancestor's Rune or the High... I think we take High Priestess. The Fool is not going to be that much use to us right now. And there is a battery charge. So we will recharge our item. Our Void here. And take this, which has given us... a Tears upgrade, in fact. A Speed and Tears upgrade, which is pretty nice. Didn't see what that pill was. Take the Ancestor's Rune, which... I mean, 4 minutes already. Kind of... taking it slowly. What was I talking about? I can't remember. Probably not. We're not really on track for boss rush because I'm still feeling my way around this character. As mentioned, I still haven't got the hang of these fucking flies, apparently, even though Afterbirth herself has been out since time began. Oh, God, help. Leave me alone. Now is when I want my Necronomicon. Oh my God, did you see that shot? What are the chances of that shot being going in that direction at this time? This is a very hard room for the basement. I assume these things hurt, rather than just block me. That's the thing we should test. Never actually, I don't think I've been hit by them yet. So we should test that they actually hurt you. Because they could just be irritations. Much like the black flies. Nice, bombs. Bombs help. Still no red heart damage as yet. Fire mine. Yeah. I don't think there's a stat upgrade that we could gain from absorbing it that would make up for the basically the raw power of fire mine. I do like it. It's dangerous, but setting things on fire is, you know, one of my favourite things to do. I do feel somewhat like an arsonist. But, you know, damage over time cannot be underrated as far as I'm concerned. Overrated. Cannot be overrated. It can be underrated and often is. Yeah, open this. Equality. I saw this on Northern Lions videos, but I still don't know what it does. I'm guessing it didn't seem to change our stats. So... that's the thing. And just in time, we have a charge on Void, ready for the Larry Jr. fight, which we could spend on the Deal with the Devil. Now, if you take a Deal with the Devil that is a Space Bar item, of course, you can pay for it, absorb it, you know, and still have it. Belly button just allows us to have another trinket and gives us another trinket, which is fine. Or we just straight up take it. Thing is, of course, a devil item that is passive, you can't buy and absorb because you can't put it back down. But if you have something like the credit card, I think literally just the credit card, if you have the credit card, you can at the very least... oh, this is okay. Make them into pedestals and then absorb them if you don't want them. I think often you're better off... Alright, we probably want to do that, but not on things that can shoot us at random. Maybe. Yeah, having the credit card with Void is actually pretty good. Oh, we can't fly, so that creep hurt. It's pretty good because many, you know, devil items kind of suck, and it feels like a shame to leave them behind. You exploded anyway, which just makes me sad. sticker him? What are the chances? Very low, I'm reasonably sure. So that could be interesting. Like if you got a brother Bobby, sister Maggie type deal with the devil. You just credit card it, turn it into pedestals, and you're golden, aren't you? Infested. Wow, okay, that was a very good time to use that pill. I'm pleased that I did. Please don't spend all my spiders on dips. The animation for the use of the Maw of the Void looks like the Reach adverts from the 1990s. Reach being a brand of toothbrush. Well, it was. Don't know if it still is. and they were advertised by a person literally opening his jaw to its fullest extent and brushing his teeth on a horizontal plane. As you do. I wonder what equality does then. Haven't really noticed anything by it. So, not get hit by that just in case it does hurt. I don't want to use... Oh, it's the next L floor as well. I don't want to use my item, which has a Necronomicon in it, because... Yes, please. Because it has a Necronomicon in it. No, because I want to use it in that exact scenario there. We want to make sure we have a charge. Well, we go into this item room, you might want to keep it. Yeah, I think we take Dry Baby, actually. A sort of an activatable Necronomicon effect. And this time we'll try and do better at the game. I find that, you know, those Eden runs that I was doing, I felt really good about it. Oh, that was terrible. Can you not make little mini monstros, though, please? You know, I felt like I was playing well, or at least okay. You know, fuck. But now I seem to be incapable of doing so. It's very frustrating. Like, what happened to my Isaac Fu?
Judgment.
That would be nice if I had any red hearts. Don't really want to spend spirit hearts on that right now. Did that thing turn into those shots when it died? Or did it happen to fire just before it died? We'll never know. Check the footage, I suppose. Can you forget me have more of the void, even though it happens every bloody room? Very easy to forget. Don't you spread that stuff around me. It's disgusting. Spirit hearts are very valuable since that's all we have to keep us going right now. Oh, I walked into that. Thank you, Dry Baby. Basically ending that room for me so I don't have to think about it. The reason I'm firing between floors, well, between rooms right now. Normally it's out of habit, just because I'm lazy and I don't want to let go of the button. Right now, it's because I want to have more of the Void Charge ready. So I'm going to take Hive Mind, and I might buy this Spirit Heart just for shits and giggles, but I'm going to save my money because I expect us to get another key at some point in the future. Wow, so more of the Void isn't actually quite enough. I mean, a full one would have been, but being poked by more of the Void was not enough to kill those mushrooms, which is outstanding. Found pills. Not what you do with pills when you find them. Very good. That's toilet paper. Let's take it. Duct tape. Very well. Stuck. Wonder what it sticks to us. Oh. All of our familiars are stuck to us. That's brilliant. I like it. I guess we just put this here. I guess it doesn't matter where we put it. I'm not going to use it to make a door. So there's our HP up. We could a little bit play that Demon Judgment. I will keep the two new trinkets rather than the old one that we've seen before. All of our familiars are now right up against us. That's actually a really good idea. If you have, if we can find something like a little brimstone is probably the most obvious use for this. Because if you take little brimstone at any point other than basically the first, or indeed Incubus, you will probably find that it's very, very difficult to control. Because the disparity between where it's firing from and where you're firing from is huge when it's at the end of a chain of familiars. So with duct tape, they're all literally stuck to. It's a little bit like Child's Leash, I think. Yeah, we'll take the HP here. We could have got a stat upgrade. I think the potential for getting stat upgrades with the Void is huge. You know, anything that doesn't do what you exactly want it to do is basically random stat upgrade. It's basically experimental treatment, but better, because slightly more likely to not be shit? Deal with the devil? No. We'll absorb that. Yeah, let's take that. So that gave us another damage upgrade. I do want to go to the curse room, but it's so far away. Fuck it. Don't care. We should use Ansu's on the mom floor. We do have a lot of stuff to do on this character. Help. Help. What? That's Dry Baby helping the hell out right now. It's not an orbital, it's literally just stuck to our face. I wonder if it changes orbitals then. Like, do orbitals just stick in position and you have to hit them, or do you think they still orbit? Oh, you died and I didn't expect you to. No, it's too late, Dry Baby. Everyone's dead. We should probably go to that mob trap room, actually. I'm trying to avoid exploding myself, but it is happening with alarming frequency. Oh, well, I guess we're going back this way, so that's okay. Let's visit this mob trap room, see if we want to get anything out of it. We're not very rich on, nope, I was going to say keys, but you have provided me with not keys. We don't really need to use more of the void for black hearts right now. I mean, I would appreciate them. I'm using it because it's doing a lot more damage than we are. It's actually a really, really decent damage upgrade. So, these things can suck my balls. I hate the fact that the creep lasts just long enough for me to forget about it. Oh, that could be useful. It means that we can use all the actual items that we have in our item and still use our item to reroll or absorb to void another item. But I have yet found the need to do this. We should probably blow these up. Could be diligent of us. Not good enough. Help, leave me alone. They come out black sometimes. I don't know if that's a champion version of them. Or if it's just because it's dark in there and they've come out of this void. More of the void looks nothing like the void, which is now a thing. I think the other thing about Antibirth is that it explores some design spaces or some concept spaces that even Afterbirth Plus doesn't. Afterbirth Plus has added, oh hello, this void idea, which seems a little bit ill-conceived. Is that what I'm trying to say? I mean, when we got Afterbirth, it added basically Hush. Hush was the new thing from Afterbirth, and we think, like, the community was, you know, waxing lyrical about what Hush could possibly represent in Edmund's larger metaphor here. But what? I'm going to use this here, and then take the moon card for purposes of getting out of boss rush. So we want to, kind of want to fight boss rush. We've used it now, so whatever. No good. We'll do this boss and then we'll fight our way to that item room and then we'll go. I want to use the, charge if possible, but I don't know. I want to use the charge because of the cool stuff that's inside it, but I also want to reroll. Oh, it's a mimic and you can tell. Okay. Sister's Fierce. Well, we're not getting through this fight anyway, so it's good knowing you. Thanks for watching. It's the end of this run. I assume the creep hurts. Okay, not seen that before. Was very much expecting that to be Brimstone. Yeah, you can just do that as much as you like. Why have you changed colour? Wow, you really got owned by that fire, didn't you? That's very true. I feel like that was a completely foreign thing for me to say. Like, sounded almost Canadian or maybe Welsh or something, didn't you? It's not a thing that people add to words. Yeah, we'll just take this because it's really good. I didn't take the HP upgrade because I think, honestly, I might reroll it and see if I can get some better stats instead. Let's yoink it. What did we get? More damage and higher rate of fire, and then we'll go and get... I'll put that there and I'll come back for it. We'll go and get this item room and we'll forget about the shop. Because we do want to make it to boss rush. I was just thinking, didn't I already do that? Yeah, I did. Just one room to the shop. One room to the item room. It's fine. can hear a voice in the background. It's really annoying. It's really not annoying. It's terrifying. Range down. Well, we got a range up, so whatever. No, we didn't. Yeah, we'll just use our infinite bombs to reroll this until it's good. Yeah, that's good. Thank you. I mean, it's maybe a little bit done, and I could have rerolled until we got something new from Afterbirth. Afterbirth Plus, but yeah. I'm sure we'll see plenty of new Afterbirth Plus content before too long anyway. Yeah, I kind of predicted that. I wanted something decent out of an item room, out of a secret room, so of course it's a shit one. The daily run was really good today, actually, if you were playing. Yeah, we've got the moon card, so we should try and get to the boss ASAP and then leave. And I think we have an advantage on Boss Rush because we're going to be able to use our void item several times as the spacebar items that we've picked up into it. There we go. Rather than, you know, the main feature that we've been using of it now so far, which is just the ability to make more spacebar items in it and not actually take advantage of that at all in any way ever. Don't really know what the purpose was there of using more of the void, since you can't reach any of these enemies, but, you know, we do what we do. Just gonna try and power through these rooms using more of the void, obviously, as a major damage dealer. So you can get to the boss, get this boss rush done. We need to do a lot of things as Apollyon right now. So, you know, we might as well try and do as many of them at once as we can. No. We'll take it because I don't know what it is. Backstabber, watch your back. Interesting. Wonder what this does. It's a passive item. Watch your back kind of implies either that there's going to be another eye involved somewhere, or maybe if something gets close to you from behind, it gets stabbed. I don't know. These things are dying a little bit more readily than I'd expect them to in normal circumstances, but I am using more of the void quite prodigiously to, oh, there goes Holy Mantle. Oh, there goes Gravity. Thank you for your assistance. We have found the boss fight, so we're quite likely to get this done within the next minute, I would imagine. The real question is, do you want to risk losing the deal with the devil opportunity to get in there if, the answer is yes, because of course you can void all four items, basically. Which, if any of them is a spacebar item, you get to keep. And all the other ones. Oh, hello. You're still alive. You turn into stats. Well, that one I don't want. I do want that, but I don't want to do it this way. The only spacebar item is one I don't want. Avoid him. That's fine. Now, I'm happy with this because, of course, we did pick up the shears some time ago. This is our first opportunity to make good on that. You know, make that actually work for us. Please. Where are you going? This way. Go faster, Rick. So we're going to have as many shears as we can cope with running around, quite honestly. As long as we have a charge at the end, so... This is wave 2. We should count them. I think it's 15 waves? 13? Oh, I don't know how many waves there are. Right, 3. Let's do that again. That spacebar item that we picked up, excuse me, is somewhat likely to hurt us because it leaves an exploding thing behind. And I'm going to forget that. That was just bad. Please leave me alone. You are the girdie that dodges, that shoots very well. I am the one who knocks. Cheers, though. You need to aggro this. All you do is shoot. So that's 2 1 2/3 charges on item. So this next wave will be the 6th. Oh no, we've used it. Yeah, twice. So 6th wave. Good. Just leave that there. It has no value to me. I mean, I would have liked Mysterious Liquid. It's a pretty good upgrade. Yeah, just don't walk into the... Is it the bloke? It is the bloke. Of course it's the bloke. Why would it not be the bloke? But I didn't even look at the stats upgrades that we bought, actually, that we won. How hard is it to make you aggro things? There we go. If you sort of stand here, it should aggro anything, right? Yeah. Watch out, Gis, you're gonna hurt somebody. Third charge coming up, that would be 9. Yeah, it's 2 each, so 9. So we'll use it again. Whoa, see, told you it hurt. I don't like that spacebar item. Unfortunately, there's no way avoiding spacebar items that suck. See what I mean? You just have to ignore them. So not all items are still necessarily useful. But I guess what it means is that any spacebar item that you would not normally take... Like, the reason you don't take spacebar items is because the spacebar item you've already got is better. But in this case, it just takes... It just gets that tiny little bit better, you know? Even if the spacebar item that you don't want has potentially valuable use. So I think we don't want to use it here. I'm slightly out of sorts with how many... There should be. I'm gonna keep hold of it in case we want to absorb the item that we get at the end. But it's good that we've done boss rushes Apollyon, that's nice. If we go a little bit faster, which is not unthinkable. Thanks to all these shears charges flying around. Apparently if you create a shears charge in exactly the wrong place, it just never comes back. Who am I waiting for? War. I think I like this synergy between more of the void and, well, we could have done it again, fire mine, because whenever I get close to an enemy, I want to stop firing in order to use more of the void, which is also true because fire mine is going to explode in my face if I don't. Locust of Conquest has appeared in the basement because we're the best. And we won a quarter, which we will... We're going to absorb it. What do we get? Shot speed and damage, I guess. Oh, we can't fly anymore. Okay. And I'll use the moon card to do some more of this floor. Okay. Pretty sure there's no way of getting this. There may yet be. Well, we can use our shears charge to get that, and I think I kind of want to. So we should recharge it. No, we can't, because if we use shears, we will absorb the item before we can get to it. That saddens me. So we need a natural way of flying. We could still absorb the item if we can't get to it any other way. Nah, not doing that. Maybe we could get a card out of something in here? I do want to save some money if we're going to go to Hush, but I don't think we're going to go to Hush at this speed because all of a sudden I'm min-maxing that. Oh, okay. Not going to it. Anyway, very well. We can't recharge our item. Oh, there is a battery. I'm going to absorb the secret room item. With the battery charge, provided we can reach it, that's in here. I'm just going to stop firing. We can. Because we can't get to it. And that's fair enough. It has given us a speed upgrade and a range downgrade, which is a fairly common thing for it to downgrade our range, which is odd. I'm not going to use a key on that shop, even though we have several, because we've got 13 cents. Well, why would I? It's probably going to contain greed, knowing me. And then I get hit several times by greed, because, you know, again, knowing me. It would just put us at a solid disadvantage. Not really what I'm after. Nah. Again, not really figured out what equality's done for us. That was a bad room. Not a fan of this room. Tinted rocks? There were a lot of fire mine explosions, if I'm being honest. You know, you expect some, but not maybe quite so many. Check red chests for, you know, spirit hearts and such like. I mean, the explosions obviously are helping. They to do quite a lot of damage, as far as I can tell. Addicted. I think that makes no difference on these floors. Or it could still be doubling our damage, which makes a great amount of difference, because now that's a full two hearts each time we get hit. We are doing a decent amount of damage. 12 damage as base, and then Fire Mine keeps exploding and doing damage over time, which is super good. No real reward for that, unfortunately. There is a Tinted Rock in here, which I saw by magic. Sure, we'll open it. That did actually work out, because it gave us the Spirit Heart that I wanted in the first place. But, I mean, I don't think we had to round-robin it in quite such a manner. Carry it. Don't know what the chariot can do for us, to be quite honest. I'm sure it could do something. Did we just destroy the entirety of that thing without me even realizing that that had happened? Apparently that is the case. I'm going to use the chariot here, because I hate Mama Gerby. Try maybe doing work. I hate the spikes, basically, so if we can do as much damage as we can, immune to the spikes. We should take the HP and then go in here. Immune to the spikes. Okay, so you remember what I was saying about credit card, brother Bobby? I think I'll keep the HP. We have a reasonable chance that deals with the devil on the next floor. Or do I want the permanent Polaroid invincibility. So, I mean, we could still get a deal with the devil on the next floor. It's going to have to be pretty good to tempt me. Just hoping for a bed. Three free spirit hearts would not go amiss. I think the luck upgrade from Magic Scab is good enough that we didn't want to avoid it. And, of course, the fact that there was a deal with the devil open and we had no red HP is kind of the obvious play at that point. But, I mean, I'm not sad that we took Magic Scab and spent the red HP immediately because on something we don't really care for, because the luck upgrade is also good. This is not making me happy. Stuck in that room. That room is very difficult to not get stuck in my limited experience. But you end up just trapped in the corner because they all dive at you at once. Don't know if there's a way out of it. Maybe there is. I've yet to suss it out. Do they use that word in other countries? Suss something out. I wonder if it's related to suspicious. I always get interested in the etymology of slang. And then it turns out to be either something horrendous, like puerile or similar, or really, really boring, like just some old word that we don't use anymore that got shortened and corrupted. Like struth. Struth comes from God's truth. Ooh, did you see that? That one was bleeding, which is an effect we've seen before on Northern Lion's stream channel videos. You know what I mean? And we didn't know what it did then. Well, Northern Lion didn't know. These things. Three black cards is definitely worth that room. That room's easy. So we've seen things bleed before, but we couldn't figure out what it was doing. It didn't appear to be damage over time. First thing that has happened in this room is that my Fire Mind tier has exploded on Mom's heart. These fires are not helping me. But I'm guessing that the stabby in the back item, which is not called Betrayal, although I feel like it should be, may have had something to do with that. Do you want to do Hush? I think if we're ever going to do Hush, now is the time. We've already knocked out a boss rush. We've killed Mom's Heart before. Maybe we do the new path, which is this way. We have enough keys. This might go horribly, horribly wrong. Horribly, horribly wrong. Okay, this is interesting. Let's have a look in the other item room first. Now I'm going to look in the shop. Okay. Bear with me. Bear with me. So we want the battery charge. We also want PhD, I think. Say PhD. We want that. We've got... I found pills. Brilliant. We've got a health upgrade, which we will save. We absorb these, because they suck. We got luck and damage, which I'm happy with. Or at least I'm okay with. Take the battery charge into the Hush fight. Which of these do we take? We could do a lot of damage with Mom's Knife, and I think we do that, because it's going to keep our damage stat, which I'm not sure if it was augmented by... I'm not sure if the damage stat was augmented by Firemind. I didn't really check. But, I mean, are we still doing fire damage? That's the real question. I think we are not. So we may have just lost... Thanks for that. excuse me. We may have lost all benefit from Firemind. But, guess that's okay. And at least if we do beat Hush, we have done it as Apollyon, which is one of the few things we have to do. There's only one new character as far as I know. Now, this is another thing. Oh, my voice! Where did my voice go? I have neglected to mention in my, you know, earlier chat on about how people have been not so happy with Afterbirth, and I'm sort of putting words into their mouth. I'm almost straw-manning it somewhat. Trying to guess why it is that they didn't like it, that they have been leaving these mixed reviews on Steam. Now, lots of people are just happy to have the new content in Isaac, which I quite understand, no doubt. And I've been assuming that it's just because the game's all weirded up. You know, there's not a huge amount of amazing new stuff. There's obviously, you know, release date bugs and stuff going on here too. This would be a great time to get Dry Baby in there, if I can manage it. The duct tape, which is definitely toilet roll, I'm just saying. That's probably one of Edmund's little jokes. Take a lot of damage here. Oh, at least the Shears are doing the right thing. Shears, you finish this off. Definitely should have taken Nord Leaf, actually. You know, hindsight, etc. Just gonna wait for this to end. Please. Enough is enough. Ah, the Shears have been thwarted by the Hushes hiding under the ground tactics. I often take damage on this very stage. And I'm a little bit salty that it didn't give me huge waves of... those particular zombie things that chase you down, because that's a great way of farming up at HP when you've got more of the void on the Hush fight. But apparently it was not to be this time. Oh, we're alive. I was trying to use more of the void, and we ended up failing miserably. Hushy has appeared in the basement. And we unlocked the void, which is the level we're probably going to go to now. There's not much more. Oh, apparently we have to come back and do it. So we have to beat Hush once. We can't do what we were going to do. We don't have any more battery charges. That's fine. I don't want that pill. I guess we go. Normally, there is hidden content. Oh, we can go in. Yeah, let's do it. Normally, there is hidden content. At least there was in Afterbirth. There was in Rebirth. You know what? Perks! Yeah, we'll take that instead of health up. That's fine. So, I guess a lot of people's reviews are based on, you know, release date bugs and lack of content. That would be my assumption about what people... Will you just fucking... I hate this enemy. Because it's reluctance to pop up is bullshit. So I'm gonna hold fire. I mean, the game's not got that much new content, and I did, you know, pay for new content, so I would kind of expect a little bit more. But at the same time, I'm expecting a lot more to suddenly show up. So, yeah, reserve judgment for now, I think. It's still decent, you know, the new parts of the game so far that I've seen have engaged my interest, especially this item that this character has, which is outrageous, to say the least. Pardon me? okay. This is the void level, by the way. The void floor. This floor is called the void. Probably don't need the key. And what it is a random assortment of rooms from other floors, which apparently occasionally just re-roll into other floors. So there you go. There are five bosses. One of which is a new one. This is not it. I don't think it has chest mechanics. I.e. I don't think you're going to get chests with items in. But we do get a second syringe there, which is very nice indeed. That was not long enough. Give me my more of the void now. Yay. Oh my god, how many more enemies are you going to spawn? That reroll was interesting. Really spooked me, actually. I didn't expect it at all. That was extremely valuable. Thank you. That was Holy Mantle versus an enemy, which then got virus. Hello, what is this? This is bomb synergy. I'm sorry. What? What have I absorbed into that thing that caused it to do that? That was a bomb synergy, so I decided to. I don't know what's happening. I decided to re-roll it. Why does it keep going white? That's what I want to know. I understood the zap. The zappy thing I understood. Oh, I was explaining that I used Holy Mantle accidentally to walk into a spider, which then got poisoned by the virus, died, and as a result, gave me a black heart. And I didn't take any damage from walking into the spider. Let's say Curse of the Void. No, Curse of the Unknown. So I don't know what the white flashes are. Okay, it was not our item that did that. We got speed, which is nice, and a bit more damage, which is also nice. Take this on the off chance that it's worth something. Just the whole floor, the room just got wiped. It's like Hagalaz, but for enemies too. Is this our trinket doing this? I am absolutely perplexed as to why every time we walk into a room, it just gets wiped. Brilliant though. Cage, okay. We just one-shot the cage, with which I am happy. I will take the habit and absorb that. Thank you. That's interesting. We don't normally see different types of hearts on that room. Look. I don't know what I've done to deserve this, but I'm very pleased. This must be something that we have, right? What we picked up recently? Nothing since arriving on this floor. I think we can let our familiars fly behind us now. I actually prefer Dry Baby behind us than where it was. Range up, sure. That seems actually decent with Mom's knife. I like having Dry Baby trail around us because... Pardon me. I don't understand. That gives us at least an opportunity to control where it is and therefore try and catch shots with it. When it was stuck to us but not orbiting, that was actually quite difficult. I have to be honest, because there was only one position where we could be in order to get Dry Baby to be hit. Now we can hide behind it again. And of course the Curved Horn, damage upgrade, very good indeed. I don't know what's happening, but I'm very much for it. This is stupendous. Every single room, it's just like everything that can be destroyed gets hit by a bomb effect, including secret rooms. Every actual rock is being destroyed. Every mushroom, every enemy, taking a shitload of damage. And I honestly don't know what's doing it. It must be... The only thing I can imagine is it's this trinket, because I'm looking down my item tracker right now. No, Void has no new spacebar item in it. You know, what did we pick up on? We picked up Kamikaze. Oh, we picked up Kamikaze. Wait, did we? Did I pick up Kamikaze? Am I that silly? It's pretty funny. Mr. Fred. Not ideal. We... Yeah, I think I may have done. That's funny too. I didn't even look at our status upgrade. That was my bad. It took Kamikaze by accident. I didn't even think of it. I just took it. Ah, this must be it. It's what we want. It is Delirium. Here we go. That's what we like to see. It took some damage, but not very much. The sun, I'm going to use that to do some damage to the enemy, but honestly, I don't think it makes that much of a difference. It's a Yera rune. I got hit by a troll bomb that came out of my justice card because I was confused. So this is Delirium. It's apparently there's a couple of bugs in it whereby it's unfinished. I will use perks on this floor, actually. I'm not sure how much damage we're taking. But I think there's a... When it animates back to this horrendous visage that it has here, it doesn't actually animate, it just teleports, it just changes and it looks weird. And you can see basically the whole boss idea is that it is mimicking all the other bosses in the same... pardon me? Okie dokie. Hello? Mom? In the same release that gave us mimic chests. Excuse me, are you mimicking two bosses right now? So if I could see my HP, I'd probably be scared, but I ain't. Can't, so I ain't. I think I just kamikaze. While in permanent Polaroid invincibility, thanks to the nun's habit, I was able to do so. You can see basically he keeps teleporting around. I don't know if it just takes enough damage and it goes somewhere else. Pardon me. Do not appreciate that sort of behavior. It also seems to have a sort of a deliriously crazed version of each boss, and it seems to get him a lot faster. That's a real boss. What the heck? That was the actual boss, not the delirium-colored version of it. Please stop teleporting on top of me. It does not make me happy. I mean, Mom's knife might not have been the right thing to take here. It's getting extremely fast. And it keeps teleporting into strange places, which is the annoying thing. I mean, every single time I've got hit, it's because the enemy has just disappeared and reappeared somewhere else while I'm trying to hit it, which is... Oh my god. Help. I mean, it's absurdly crazy. I grant you this. Very upsetting. Trying to keep up with it. And I don't seem to be able to melee it, so I have to hit it with Mom's knife, which is turning out to be extremely hard. Because it won't stay the heck still. I don't know what boss it is at any particular point. It keeps doing that, which is making it very difficult to dodge anything. Can you not? I assume it... What? I was going to say, I assume it isn't doing anything when it's doing that weird room-changing attack, but it also died as a result. I think what happened was that whilst it was doing that, the Shear's body was doing damage to it. But let's watch this. Was the skeleton Isaac? New character gonna? Is that a teaser for a new character that we haven't unlocked yet? This is a long ending, actually. Well, that's really loud. Excuse me. Void. Yes, you can now pick up Void. Delirious is a pit in the basement. Cool. That was as enigmatic as any episode, as any ending of Isaac. has ever been. I'm sure the community will have a lot to say about that. I'm going to sit passively by and wait for other people to figure out what that was all about, but maybe we are looking at another version of Dead Isaac? Maybe, maybe not. Well, that's been an hour long. I apologize for the terrible play, but at least we got through the delirium fight. I hope you enjoyed watching that. That's a lot of new content in that one episode, so I hope you enjoyed watching it, and thank you for sticking with me through all these hour and 40-odd seconds of it. But until next time, I am going to be playing a lot more of this, and I'm going to be hoping that you'll be joining me for it, and I'm going to be talking in this weird tense for the majority of it. So I hope you'll join me next time, and I'll see you then.